If you are looking for tips about passing the Certified Kubernetes Application Developer Exam, you've come to the right video. In this video, I'm gonna give you 5 tips I wish I had known before taking the CKAD exam for the first time. I've taken the exam twice now, so I've got some decent experience with it. Let's get right to it. The first tip I'll give you is to make sure you connect to the correct cluster and work in the specified namespace. Part of working in a Kubernetes cluster is being able to answer 2 questions. Am I connected to the right cluster? Am I working in the right namespace? For context, I had 16 questions total on my first exam. The exam lasted 2 hours, so I'd recommend spending about 5 minutes per question. I worked on 4 different Kubernetes clusters. I worked in 14 different Kubernetes namespaces. Multiple questions use the default namespace. Essentially, every question worked in a different combination of cluster and namespace, so I had to change cluster and or namespace for every question. The exam does make it easy to know which cluster you should be connected to and which namespace you should be working in. The CKAD exam is a performative style exam, so you have to be able to work in an actual Kubernetes cluster in order to be able to pass it. Do not go into this exam thinking it's a multiple choice exam. If you do, you will fail, because this exam has no multiple choice questions. You have to be able to actually use a Kubernetes cluster, work with objects in the cluster, write manifest files, and understand how to build and export container images. You need to have a good working model of how the various Kubernetes objects work and tie together in a functional way. The next tip is to be able to understand how to determine the state of objects in the cluster and be able to troubleshoot Kubernetes objects. The biggest skill that's tested in the exam, in my experience, is the ability to troubleshoot the state of objects in a cluster and get them to a different state. I'd recommend being able to do this for pods, deployments, daemon sets, replica sets, services, ingresses, network policies, jobs, cron jobs, persistent volume claims, et cetera, et cetera, et cetera. If I had to pick 5 of these to know how to do this for, it would be pods, deployments, services, ingress, and volumes. For example, if you were looking at a pod that has 2 containers running as part of the pod, can you figure out what images the 2 containers are using? If one of the containers is using the wrong image, how do you get the pod to be running both containers with the correct image for each container? How can you get to the logs of the desired container in a given pod to double check? When you are studying and practicing, also make sure you are looking up information for the current version of the exam, because it may be different than what you've been practicing on. In my case, my first exam was being tested on Kubernetes version 1.25, but I had been practicing on a Kubernetes version 1.24 cluster. The third tip I'm gonna give you is to know how to write Kubernetes manifest files and use them to apply, modify, and delete Kubernetes objects. This might sound trivial if you've been working with Kubernetes for a while, but on multiple questions, I had to write my own manifest for 1 or more objects in the Kubernetes cluster. There were a couple of situations that I didn't know the exact syntax for the Kubernetes objects in the manifest file, so I spent some time going through the Kubernetes documentation, trying to find an example for what I was working on. I'd encourage you to get familiar with the Kubernetes documentation, because you can use it to help you during the exam. But if you aren't exactly sure where to look to find the answer you need, then you're going to waste valuable time trying to find the answer for what you're looking for. For my next tip, I'm going to build on the previous one and tell you to make copies of the Kubernetes manifest files before working on them. In a number of the questions, you will be told where a manifest file is. I recommend that you go to that location, make a backup of the manifest file, and then work on a copy of the manifest file so you can always get back to the original state of the Kubernetes object if needed. This will help you out if you decide to work directly with the Kubernetes object in the cluster and need to get back to the starting state. I'd also recommend knowing how to dump out an existing Kubernetes object into a manifest file that you can work with. You may also want to know what fields are optional, because when you dump out a manifest file of an existing Kubernetes object, you're gonna get extra fields that you won't use and that you actually may need to delete before you can successfully apply the modified file. Finally, for my 5th tip, know how to use man, curl, wget, docker, and vi commands. I got a few questions I had to look up the syntax for command using the man documentation. I'm used to working on a Mac OS machine, but the CKAD exam used a Linux virtual machine, so there were slight variations in the commands I'm used to running. I'd use the curl command to inspect a deployment, service, and ingress resource to figure out what to do to solve a problem on the CKAD exam. When I edited objects directly in the Kubernetes cluster, I was dumped into a VI or Vim-based editor. So knowing what normal mode and insert mode are and how to switch between the two is helpful. In addition, being able to move around a file, save a file, and exit a file in VI or Vim is also helpful. You don't have to be a master of Vim, but a rudimentary understanding would be helpful if you accidentally get tossed into that editor. Because you stuck around to the end of the video, one final bonus tip is to leverage training resources like A-Cloud Guru, Udemy, and the Linux Foundation, in addition to killer.sh. The first three I mentioned, A-Cloud Guru, Udemy, and the Linux Foundation, have specific courses to help you to prepare for the CKAD exam. Killer.sh is a website that allows you to take a mock version of the CKAD exam, so I'd highly recommend that as well. When you sign up for the exam, you get two mock exams using killer.sh, so be sure to take advantage of that resource. As always, thanks for watching my content. Like this video if you found it helpful, and stick around for my next video on AWS and DevOps. Until next time.